Hey everyone, this is Yen from Devolutions with this week's Remote Desktop Manager Pro Tip. Now, amongst one of Remote Desktop Manager's most powerful features is the checkout system. Now, the checkout system is pretty much exactly like what you're thinking it is. It's like when you used to go and check out a book from the library, and then that book is assigned to you, it's locked from everybody else, so everybody else has to wait till you check it back in before they can access that book. And if you don't check it back in, well, there was always those famous library fines. Now, don't worry, in Remote Desktop Manager, we're not gonna fine you for not checking back in your session on time. But we do have a couple features that I wanted to show you today that you may not be aware of with this checkout system. Now, first of all, we just want to let you know that the check-in checkout system is only available in SQL Server as well as Devolution Server data sources. So if you're not using those, it's not going to be a feature available for you. And the checkout feature is available for quite a lot of different types of entries, from credentials to session types. You can even set it up on documents so that they're read-only for other people. So there's a lot of different reasons why you may want to lock a entry or a specific session. For example, if you are doing maintenance on a server, you don't necessarily want people going in there while you're performing the upgrade. So it'd be wise for you to check out that session, provide a comment so everybody knows and it's logged the reason why you're checking it out. And you can even set a time limit so that you don't forget to check it back in. We also introduced a force check-in option for administrators. So if a user checked out a session or an entry over the weekend and then everybody was locked out of it, well, now an admin can actually force check it in. So today I just want to give you a quick overview about how to set up options and maybe show you some things that you didn't know about the checkout system. So let's take a look at my screen. So first of all, I'm going to be logged in as an administrator so I can set everything up. So I'm using Maurice. So if I click on properties on the root folder here, I can go to security settings. As an admin, you can set checkout options on either the root folder, a folder itself, or a session or an item. Now there's a few various checkout modes available. Obviously, the first one, not available, means that you can't check out the entry at all. So you can't right click or try to check it out. It's just not going to be available whatsoever. In automatic mode, the checkout process happens automatically, meaning that the item, the session, whatever entry you're using will be checked out to that specific user without them having to do anything. Now, you can force them to have a modal window which will pop up where they can put a comment and to automatically check in after a certain amount of time. Now, if they right click and go on the properties, the checkout process will not engage at all. That would happen in the manual mode. In the manual mode, it's kind of a step above the automatic, meaning it's gonna prompt them, you need to check this out before you do anything. Even if they right click on properties because they wanna edit something, the modal window will pop up. So this kind of gives an extra step to warn them, you need to check this thing out regardless of if you wanna run the session, execute it, or click and view properties. Also in manual mode, you're gonna have to make sure that you check in each entry manually. This is not gonna be done automatically like in the other mode. So this is a little bit more of an in-depth checkout process. Optional checkout mode will allow you to give the user the options so they don't have to check it out. They can still open the session, they can still right click and go to properties, but they can also right click and say check out if they need to. So it all depends on your needs and use case for which one you want to set. Now for this demo, I want to force the checkout in automatic mode for the following three items here, this document here, as well as these two RDP sessions. Now, another thing that I did beforehand was to set each one of these checkout modes on these three entries to be inherited because you wanted it to get from the folder up above as we set that one to automatic. So I did that for all three of the entries. So I'm gonna click on the Montreal folder here. I'm gonna right click and go to properties. And in the properties, I'm gonna go down to security settings. And then here the checkout mode is not available because we didn't set it in the root. I'm gonna say automatic. Now there's one that I didn't show you earlier because it wasn't available, but there's also this inherited. Now this inherited one means that the checkout mode will be inherited by the parent folder, not just the root folder at the top, okay? So here, let's say automatic. I want it to force the checkout prompt to happen with all the items below. Let's just try to open up an RDP session here. So now you'll notice here, I've got this little checkout button here so I can check it out, but I actually wanna check it out and open it automatically. So let's just click open session. My comment window pops up saying upgrading server, okay. And then on the here, you'll see the little icon on the left that has a little green little button with a little arrow sticking out. Now I know that it's checked out. Let's check out this document file. So I'm gonna go say open session here and I say need to revise document. Okay, I'm gonna go here. Here we got some release notes, some information here. My user can go in and add new steps here. I can add here. So removed a feature. Now to see this thing in full action, let's see what it looks like for a user that is not an administrator. So here I'm gonna log in as Kelly. And Kelly is not an admin, but she has access to the server. She can run RDP sessions, she can edit files. So here she logs in and notice under the Montreal folder, here there's a little red little icon and it actually tells me it's checked out by Maurice. So what happens if she wants to actually go ahead and edit this document? Well, she can click open session. She can't edit this because we don't want two people editing the same document at the same time. It's opened up in read-only mode. Now here, this RDP session, same thing. They can't open it because it is locked out for their use. Now here's the problem. Now let's say Kelly comes in on the weekend. She actually has to perform more updates on this server, but Maurice is gone. He's on vacation. So how can she get this back in? Well, she's gonna have to contact an admin that is available, like Bob, for example, and say, hey, Bob, can you go and check this back in for me? So Bob comes in. And then Bob sees, oh man, yeah, Maurice definitely did check it out. So he can go in and click check in or click the little icon here as well. And now once he checks it back in, Kelly, she can go back into this session herself and then she's gonna say automatically check in. And then now it'll say the session is opened up. Why? Because Maurice still had it open up in his window. Well, she can still, she checked it out. So she'll click continue. And now we'll see here. So Kelly's finished on the weekend doing all our work. If she goes and closes it out, it'll automatically check it back in. So the whole system is ready to go and it won't be locked out for anybody else. Now, if you want more information on the checkout feature, I encourage you to check out the help file and see more information about how this feature works. If you enjoy this type of content, like and subscribe to our channel for more, and we'll do our absolute best to come up with more content just like this. Thanks again, and have a great rest of your week. Bye.